All right, welcome to the Pokémon box break, people. Today we're going to be opening up this box. It's a Urentis VMAX. And you know, it's a pretty sweet box. You can see the VMAX right there. It's worth quite a bit of money. You get the Eternatus V. We get about 6 booster packs, so it's pretty cool. And then we get the big card with it, which is also a VMAX. But yeah, so today we're going to be basically opening up this and see what we can get in. Hopefully we can get some pulls, people. Hopefully we can get some big ones. If you guys are new to the channel, subscribe. It's free to do so. Takes you a second. And it helps you find your way back to me. I do gaming, but I have been also venturing into Pokemon. Back into Pokemon. And obviously other TCG cards. We have Disney or Locana to open up next. But I think that I'm also going to be ordering some Lord of the Rings magic boxes as well. Because I am a huge Lord of the Rings fan. So it would just make sense, you know? It would make complete sense to do that. Alright. Let's go ahead and start opening up this huge plastic box. The Eternatus VMAX. My camera would work with me. Here we go. It's a little bit better. It's a nice pattern to it. I like the design. Looks pretty sweet. Alright. So, you know, you guys already know the order of business. I've come to appreciate Pokemon creators now and TCG card players and open box people because it's a lot harder than you guys realize. You're having to, like, juggle around the equipment. There it is. So the centering is okay. I feel like the centering is good enough. Is it gradable? Yeah, it looks like it is kind of a gradable card. Next card. Is the Eternatus V. Again, a pretty sweet card. We probably should penny sleeve this as soon as possible. The centering on this card is pretty good. Left, the right is a little bit thin. The left is a little bit thick. But, I mean, how's the back look? I don't really want to screw the card too much. Again, the left is thick. The right is thin. So the centering isn't exactly spot on, but the card quality obviously is brand new, but it's a really nice design. Yeah, I'm not sure the value of this one, but we'll have to look it up later. Cool. So those are the two promo cards that come with it. Let's go ahead and get into these actual main packs. So what you get is Vivid Voltage. You get Battle Styles. You get Rebel Clash. You also get, again, Battle Styles. You get Darkness of Blaze. Darkness of Blaze is a pretty good suit. It's pretty sweet. And then you get the Sword and Shield. So those are all the boosters you get with this. Isn't bad. Don't ask me for the code cards. I don't do code cards. Okay. So I think we should start this off with Battle Styles. So we can rip into you. So we can pull here. Yo, that's a really thin pack. That is ripped so easy. Seemed too easy. Like it was resealed, but it's not because it's sealed product. I bought it from the store, so I should know. Alright, so we got Bellsprout. Electabuzz. Gligar. Is that Honedge? Scatterbug, Gyarados, holographic, okay, that's not bad. We got a Galarian Slowbro, obviously the energy card, which we give away. And then we've got the Rapid Strike Style Mustard Trainer card. Another Trainer card, Bruno. And then stage 1 Gliscor. So that pack was like blah. The only one I would sleeve is probably this reverse holographic right here, stage 2. This guy right here. Let's look at the centering on it. Centering's not bad. This card isn't exactly worth a lot, but it's a cool design, I guess. And it's a reverse holographic, or it's a holographic, so that's good. It's always nice. Yeah, okay. Cool. Most of these cards we can just kind of just put in a pile over here. Now, if you guys have noticed, this is how I open the cards. So I'll look at the card, I'll go battle style, sweet. Then I'll rip into the pack. But I don't scratch the cards up. Like, I'll hold it like this. Bronzor. And then I'll kind of like just lift it off. Send a lint. Just in case there's a huge hit card. But it just creates a habit. If you can take care of like low value cards, you can take care of high value cards. I should be a grader really. Because I have that kind of, oh my god, I see a shiny. I have that mentality of taking care of my own cards and other people's cards. Electabuzz. A holographic Sandaconda. Okay, that's definitely a... Oh my god! Single strike Urshifu VMAX. Oh my goodness, this is a massive hit. Go on, get out of here, Snuggles. Oh my god! Holy crap. This is a huge hit. I'm definitely going to sleeve this right away. Oh my god. Guys and girls to the channel. We just pulled an absolute banger right now out of this pack. I think this is the one that's worth a couple $100. Because I have one that's similar to this, but this one looks better. Oh my god. Look at the centering, it's spot on as well. Really nice centering. Oh my god, this is gradable. This is going to be a gradable card. It probably come back with a 9. It looks like it's slightly off on the back. And there might be a little whitening to the edges where it came from the factory. That sucks. It's such a nice card too. Why would someone do that? A little bit of white showing. This is going to be a 9. Maybe even an 8 or a 9. But oh my god, look at that. A 168, 163. Single strike. Urshifu VMAX. God, what a banger. Nice. That's definitely our best card so far, people. Without a doubt. Without a doubt. Okay, so next we're going to sleeve up this bad boy, Sandaconda. Any holographic cards, I like to put a seal on them. Just to be sure. You know? Okay. Let's get back through the rest of the pack. Energy card, just recycle it. Spewpa. Level ball trainer card, and then we've got a Buffalant basic, and then code card. I just recycle that too. Okay, cool. Moving on to our next pack, people. So far, so good. Sword of Shield Rebel Clash. All right. I mean, we paid $30 for this massive box, and I've already pulled a card that's like $100, so we already made our money back and more. This is really good news, by the way, people. You do know I'm a level 3 TCG player seller too, right? And I'm going to be a level 4 in like a couple of weeks, most likely. I just have to keep plugging away and grinding. And appreciate all you guys buying cards for me on my TCG player, Mike Z Gamer store. Thank you guys very much for the support. This is Bronzor Basic Toxel. Applin. Dude, as soon as I seen that shiny card earlier, I knew it. Galarian Darumaka. Bunabi. Holo Impidib. There we go. Galarian Cassola. I haven't seen this card before. It's a cool looking one. Definitely gonna sleeve those up. Energy card, recycle it. And DDD. This is a Charabug. Stage 1. Okay. Stage 1 Metapod. Okay. And then recycle the code cards. Just sleeve these two up right here. Like I said, it doesn't matter if it's worth a penny or $1 million. If it's got holo on it or some foil, I sleeve it. It's just a habit. I just like the, you know, I mean, I know they're more valuable. Usually. there's a 99% chance it's got value to it if it's got holographic or some kind of shiny to it, some kind of foil. Doesn't matter what kind of TCGs you get into, it's kind of like the same rule of thumb across the board. All right, let's set these to the side, shall we? Next pack we got is a Sword of Shields Vivid Voltage. Okay, take a look at this bad boy, shall we? All right, we got a Chatot, a Cottonee, we got a Joltik. That just slid down. See, I'm being very careful with the cards here. A Mudbray, a Slugma, a Woobat Holo. Oh my goodness, here we go, Steelix V. Okay, I like the artwork on this one. I'm not sure the value of this, but the artwork is cool. Centering wise, in terms of if we're going to get it graded or not, centering is okay. A little bit thin on the left, a little bit thick on the right, a little bit thin on the top, a little bit thick on the bottom. So centering isn't great, but it's okay. Definitely going to sleeve these two bad boys up for sure. Recycle, Shuckle, Nuzleave, Memory Capsule, and Enco card. Recycle. No, I don't rotate the cards so that I have just the cards I want to open up first. I just, as the pack is how I open it. That way you guys know this is 100% legit. Nothing has been fabricated. Nothing has been, you know, staged. It's all legit. 100%. You guys know how I roll. You've been on my channel long enough to realize. Okay, so here we go. I like to keep things in order. You know, I don't need the click money, even though it would be nice, but I'm not going to fake my way to the top. That's not how I am. I'll get my way to the top legitimately. If it takes longer, that's fine. We got Aaron. We got Starly. Pure Leon. If I butcher the names, the pronunciations, I'm sorry. There's like 5,000 Pokemon. It's hard, it's a little bit difficult to get it right all the time. Mariani. Meltan, a Flaffy, but it's holographic, so I like that one. We're going to put that to the side and sleeve it up. Ampharos, recycle my energy cards, which I do. Ferret, what is this? Steenie, we've got a Burrkeeper, I've seen this before. And we've got a co-card. So in that pack was kind of a dud. That was a really bad pack. But that's fine, because you're not going to get bangers all the time. That's for damn sure. We all know this. Centering this card is a little bit thin to the left, a little bit thick to the right. Top and bottom is set fairly even. And the back is around the same proportions. I actually know some guy who works at PSA, by the way. He doesn't work directly for PSA, but they work with PSA. He's kind of a cool guy. He's in the mall. Okay, so Sword and Shield. Sword and Shield. Let's get into it. Yeah, he works out in Rockford Mall in Illinois. They got like a PSA thing where they take in PSA cards and I think they distribute it out to the people, to the stores and all that. And Sizzlypeed. Rookie D. Is that Ghastly? Got a Sandalint, a Drizzle, a holographic, and we'll definitely sleeve that one up. Stonjanor. Okay, recycling that card. We got a Bisharp. We got a I can't even pronounce it. Salazul? Yeah, it's gotta be. Evolution Incense, and then that. Pull two there. That was a heavy card. Got some weight to it, that card. Okay, let's go ahead. I'm going to go for the hit cards afterwards. I'm going to show you guys. I'm going to try and guess which order in value and in power, of course, as well, if you guys are playing the card game. Okay, so here we go. Let's go back through the fly. Go back through the hits. If you guys get offended, I'm sorry. And I don't care either, because it's a game, people. Alright, so, here we go. Starting with the most unvaluable and the weakest. Let's just do this. This is too difficult in this camera angle. Here we go. Impidimp. Value-wise, power-wise, you know, common, uncommon, rare, whatever. Woobat. Flaffy. Galarian Crisola. Sandaconda. Gyarados. Drizzly. Eternus V.
Wait a second.
Where's my Eternus V Max? Eternus V.
Okay, there it is.
Steelix V, which I feel like I had those two backwards. So no, I correct this. Steelix V, Eternus V, Eternus V Max. Camera needs to focus. Okay, that right there. And then the your Shifu V Max. This card is absolutely beautiful. All right, people. Let me know in the comment section what you think about the pools today. And if you guys are new to the channel, make sure you subscribe. Drop a like, drop a comment, and let me know how your TCG cards have been pulling this week. Whatever suit you're playing. And I'll see you in the next one. I think next we'll be pulling some Disney Locana boxes. So hopefully we get some big hits, and we can add it to the inventory for TCG Player. And if you guys would like to check out my store, I'll leave it I'll leave it in the description box for my TCG Player store. All right, people. Peace out. Have a good day. And you guys, hopefully you get some good dubs and some wins this week in your games and your pools. Peace out. Bye-bye.